In the preceding videos, I talked in a basic way about the thermodynamics of individual chemical reactions. Now we can start to look at how chemical reactions are put together to form metabolic pathways and how these pathways are regulated. Metabolism is the combined sum of the chemical reactions that occur in living organisms. Metabolism is traditionally divided into catabolism and anabolism. Catabolism, shown on the left side of this diagram, is the breaking down of large, more complex molecules into smaller, simpler ones. Anabolism, shown on the right, is the combining of small, simple molecules to make larger, more complex ones. As a general rule, catabolic pathways provide energy to the cell, while anabolic pathways consume energy. Metabolic pathways are coordinated series of reactions that make specific products in a living system. Almost all metabolic reactions are catalyzed by enzymes. We can imagine a 10-step pathway in which some compound, compound 1, is converted to compound 2, which in turn is converted to compound 3, and so on, to the final product, compound 11. As is true for an individual chemical reaction, for the metabolic pathway as a whole to proceed in the forward direction, the overall delta G for the pathway must be negative. To illustrate the changes in Gibbs free energy along the pathway, we could draw a diagram similar to a reaction coordinate diagram in which the metabolites are numbered from 1 to 11 along the x-axis, and the y-axis represents Gibbs free energy. In this example, three reactions have large negative delta G values. You may recall that such reactions are said to be irreversible. The rest of the reactions are near equilibrium and are reversible. This is typical of metabolic pathways in general. Most steps are at or near equilibrium, while a few steps have very negative delta G values. Thermodynamically speaking, the irreversible reactions drive metabolic pathways forward. The rate at which molecules flow through a metabolic pathway is called the flux. The cell must be able to change the flux of molecules through a pathway in response to changing conditions. Under some conditions, it may be desirable to produce a lot of compound 11, but under other conditions, it may be desirable to stop production of compound 11. The cell can control flux through the pathway by altering the activity or catalytic efficiency of enzymes that catalyze reactions within the pathway. I'll explain how enzyme activity can be changed in the next video, but for now, just assume that it is possible to increase or decrease the ability of an enzyme to catalyze its specific reaction. The question becomes, which reaction or reactions are the best targets for regulation? Let's consider first a reaction near equilibrium, such as the conversion of compound 5 to compound 6. If the activity of the enzyme catalyzing this reaction were increased tenfold, what would be the impact on the net rate of conversion of 5 to 6? Would net production of 6 increase, decrease, or stay the same? You might want to pause the video and think about the answer. The correct answer is C. This reaction starts at equilibrium, meaning that the rate of the forward reaction equals the rate of the reverse reaction. Because enzymes are reversible, when their activity is increased, both directions of the reaction are affected equally. So, increasing the activity of this enzyme tenfold makes the forward reaction tenfold faster, and the reverse reaction also tenfold faster. So if the initial reaction rate was 1 unit in each direction, the final reaction rate is 10 units in each direction. There is no net change in conversion of compound 5 to compound 6. Now let's consider a reaction far from equilibrium, such as the conversion of compound 3 to compound 4 in our example metabolic pathway. If the activity of the enzyme catalyzing this reaction were increased tenfold, what would be the impact on the net rate of conversion of 3 to 4? Would net production of 4 increase, decrease, or stay the same? The correct answer is A. This reaction is highly energetically favorable, meaning that the forward reaction is occurring at a faster rate than the backward reaction. Therefore, even though the reaction rates are both multiplied by 10, the absolute change in rate is larger in the forward direction. The difference in reaction rates becomes larger after enzyme activation. For example, if the initial rates were 100 units in the forward direction and 1 unit in the reverse direction, the final rates would be 1,000 and 10 units, respectively. The difference in reaction rates increases tenfold from 99 to 990. Therefore, compound 3 is converted to compound 4 much more quickly after enzyme activity has been increased. An analogous result would occur if enzyme activity were decreased. A reaction at equilibrium would be unaffected, while a reaction with a large negative delta G would be considerably slowed. In this video, we have seen that irreversible reactions, or reactions that are far from equilibrium, are optimal points at which to control the flux through a metabolic pathway. Frequently, irreversible reactions are found as the first reaction in a pathway or right after a branch point. But how does the cell change the activity of enzymes to control flux through metabolic pathways? In the next video, I'll explain some ways in which enzyme activity can be changed.